So, what happened to living on love and music, Miranda?
I lost faith in myself, in us. There were no opportunities for me then, and I was terrified I'd be dependent on a broke musician the rest of my life.
Mrs. Valentine got to you.
The times got to me.
And so, I told Bingo he had to give up everything that he was.
It was a lie, of course. Bingo was tremendously talented.
But talent ain't the same as security.
And the next morning, Bingo was dead. Turns out, security doesn't exist.
Do you remember the first time you were this age, when I sat you and your sisters down and we had the talk?
Crams, I already know all about sex, and no offense, but I don't want to talk about it with you because that's really gross.
No, not the sex talk, silly. The witch talk.
So what did you tell us?
My being a witch was such a important part of my life, and what it meant to me and what it might mean to you someday.
Did you tell us that Prue and Mom were gonna die? Or that Leo was gonna lose his marbles?
Piper, I didn't know any of those things were going to happen. But if I did, I would have done everything in my power to stop it. I'd like to think that being a witch gave you the inner strength you needed to deal with all those sadnesses in your life. Did you ever think about that?
No.
You see, in addition to Cammie's bad behavior, she has excused absences for 18 out of the last 30 school days. So, she's just failing all of her classes.
You're right, like I'm coming back to the school.
There you go. Why not drop out of school altogether? I mean, girls with no education have more fun than anyone. I mean, think of all the free time, no rules, no boundaries. Hey, she could get baked every day. Or you could hang out at the mall. Or how about she decides to follow, say, a grassroots symphony, you know, touring through town or something like
that. Okay.
At first, you know, it's just an acoustical adventure. But then she falls in love with the conductor.
And then she finds herself
marrying him in some vaguely satanic ritual involving a drum circle, two oboes, and free, throbbing love. Years of nomadic living go by in a blue, druggy haze until one time she wakes up and finds herself pregnant. And in the bleakest of Idaho, and then cradling her infant son, she has to start her life anew. She's tormented by flashbacks of what she used to think of as